આવજો રે તે તો ભણવા આવજો, ભણવા આવજો રે તે તો ભણવા આવજો, મારા ડુંગરપુરના લોગ લુગાઈ ભણવા આવજો, મારા ડુંગરપુરના લોગ લુગાઈ ભણવા આવજો.
When India became independent, 23 princely states were consolidated to form the state of Rajasthan. The princely state of Dungarpur was one of them. Dotted with picturesque low hillocks, the district takes its name from the word Dungar, meaning hills in the local Vagri dialect. Located in the southern tip of Rajasthan and bordering Gujarat, Dungarpur has a substantial Bhil population. These hills were thickly forested not very long ago, and the local community met its daily needs with ease and comfort from the forest wealth. Like forests elsewhere, the commercial exploitation of the forests has led to the denuding of the hills, and the terrain today is rugged and arid. Unused to agriculture, the Bhils had to take up cultivation on the slopes and eke out a meager existence. The soil was hard and dry, and the lack of irrigation and low rainfall made only a single crop possible annually. Even earlier, the Dungarpur region was poor, but the deforestation has made survival very difficult, leading to large-scale seasonal migration to the industrial townships in neighboring Gujarat and beyond. Dungarpur has no established industrial units, and the village-based handicrafts and cottage industry is not sufficient to provide economic livelihood to the population of the area. All development is heavily dependent on the resources provided by the government. Educationally too, Dungarpur has been very backward, with a literacy rate of 36.68% for men and 12.44% for women, according to the 1991 census. The princely rulers were obviously not in favor of educating the people and did their best to prevent the spread of education. The story goes that in a village called Rastapal, a small village school was being run by Sengabhai in Nanabhai Khant's house. The police came to close the school. In the ensuing confrontation and tussle, Nanabhai Khant and Kalibai, a young girl of the village, were killed. The story of their martyrdom is still alive in the public memory in Dungarpur. Life in Dungarpur is very hard. Since many of the men are away from the village in search of work, it is the women who bear the brunt of running the home and caring for the children. Fetching fodder, fuel wood and water, walking long distances, these women have a difficult life. Usually, the source of water had been the traditional step wells, which was also the cause of guinea worm infestation, known as Naru in the local language. The high prevalence of this disease was a cause for much concern, and the government took up a special program under the National Drinking Water Mission to eradicate the guinea worm infestation from the area. The disease also caused long-term debility among people, reducing their productivity even further.
In 1986, में जब ये प्रोजेक्ट शुरू हुआ था, उस समय करीब 8,000 नारू रोगी यहाँ पर डूंगरपुर डिस्ट्रिक्ट के अंदर थे. जिन जिन पॉकेट्स को हमने मालूम पड़ा है, वहाँ पर जो एपीओ टेक्निकल है वो ध्यान दे करके और वहाँ जो जो भी स्टेप बेल्स कौन कौन से हैं उनको उनका कन्वर्शन करना, हाइड्रोजियोलॉजिस्ट के माध्यम से हैंडपम्प इंस्टॉलेशन करवाने का काम कराया गया वहाँ पर, और वो ग्रामवासी जिनको कि इसके बारे में कुछ पता नहीं था कि सुरक्षित पेयजल स्रोत क्या भला होती है, उनको इस बात का ज्ञान दिया गया कि भाई के यदि तुम बंद बावड़ी का पानी पियोगे और हैंडपम्प का पानी पियोगे तो वो आप लोगों के लिए बहुत ही सुविधाजनक रहेगा और साथ ही साथ सुरक्षित रहेगा, आप लोग बीमार नहीं पड़ोगे और केवल नारू की बीमारी से दूर नहीं होगे, आप कितनी प्रकार की जो पानी से होने वाली बीमारियां हैं उनसे भी आप लोग दूर हो जाओगे। तो उन लोगों को ये बतलाया गया और बतलाने से वो लोग आज ये स्थिति हो गई है कि 1991 में आकर के केवल हमारे पास में 250 नारू रोगी बच गए हैं।
The effort of the National Drinking Water Mission has had an impact. Executed with the support of local voluntary agencies and a sustained health education campaign using posters and other popular media, the objective was to provide safe drinking water to every household through the installation of hand pumps. Families were educated regarding the ill effects of the step wells, and gradually these have been abandoned. The partnership between the district administration and the voluntary agencies has been a fruitful one.
बीमारी ते नारू नकले फिर उगाड़ू रहते गंदू पानी आवे नकले पण कम नकले बिल्कुल अवे हैंडपंप पानी पियन।
पिछले सालों में ड्रिंकिंग वाटर पर और एजुकेशन और वेस्टलैंड डेवलपमेंट इस पे ज़्यादा काम किए।
There is a feeling of hope among the people of Dungarpur, encouraged as they are with the visible signs of change. The success of the water supply program has been followed by a massive afforestation and wastelands development program, attempting to green the hills of Dungarpur once again. However, it is the launch of the Total Literacy Campaign, TLC, in 1991 that has converted people's participation in development programs into a social movement.
हम अनपढ़ लोग हैं, हमको कोई हर चीज लेने जाते हैं तो हम ठग जाते हैं।
दूध पीते हैं जिसका हिसाब लिखना पड़ता है।
बिना पढ़े भी, लेकिन बिना पढ़े जो कोई हमारे साथ में बैठा हो, हमारे आगे हो, पीछे हो, तो वो कहते हैं कि हे साला डांगा क्या क्या करता है, पैसे दे पैसे दे। तो हम जेब में 2 रुपये तो इसको हमने 1 रुपया मांगता है और 2 रुपया मांगता है तो पूरे पूरे हमको इसको देना पड़ेगा।
50,000 पूछे बोलना, 50,000 कौन पूछे।
हम अनपढ़ हैं, कोई आता है कागज चिट्ठी लेके है तो हम दूसरे ठिकाने बचवाने जाते, हमको बुरा लगता है।
Discouraged and handicapped by their own lack of education, the people have come forward to take part in the Total Literacy Campaign, responding with enthusiasm to the invitation to learn.
भाई बहनों बनवा अब जो
Inspired by the success of the literacy campaign in Kerala, the state government of Rajasthan and the district administration proposed a total literacy campaign for Dungarpur with the objective of making over 3 lakh persons in the age group 9 to 40 years functionally literate over a 2-year period between 1991 and 93. A subsidiary effort was to enroll all children in the age group 6 to 8 years in the primary schools. The most important and crucial feature of the literacy campaign has been the social mobilization effort, whereby the entire community has become involved in the campaign. People have come forward spontaneously to participate in the campaign, contributing their own little mite. The National Literacy Mission symbol has become the new icon, Akhar Dev, venerated in every house, welcoming the advent of literacy and learning. Bhagats are traditional bards who are known for their integrity and character. They are highly respected in the community. This fact is used in the environment building for the total literacy campaign, where the puppet plays use the Bhagat character to deliver the messages of literacy and education.
ये हम मकना भगत बना रहे हैं
ये इसका क्या इस्तेमाल करेंगे
एक्चुअली में जो हमारी आखर चौपड़ी बनी है उसमें सारे संदेश मकना भगत के द्वारा दिए गए हैं और इसके जो मुख्य पृष्ठ है उस पे भी मकना भगत की तस्वीर है और ये हमारे यहाँ ऐसा व्यक्ति है जो बहुत ही सम्माननीय है गाँव में जो अगर कोई भी बात कहे तो गाँव वासी सारे मानने के लिए तैयार हैं तो हमने इसी रूप में ये पपेट बनाई है छड़ पुतली तो ये हमारे गांव में जो प्रोग्राम्स हो रहे हैं उनमें इतने से कंडक्ट करने का काम करेगा
आने सब भाई ने भाई थकी मैं बात करूं ने हमली ने बराबर तुम्हें ध्यान में रखसु के आप बनाई काडी है सरकारी ने आनाम बराबर
अपार्ट फ्रॉम पपेट शोज नुक्कड़ नाटक्स फोक सॉन्ग्स पोएम्स एंड स्किट्स आर यूज्ड इन द कल्चरल प्रोग्राम्स ऑर्गेनाइज्ड टू प्रमोट द लिटरेसी कैंपेन द लोकल बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स वर ट्रेन्ड थ्रू डिस्ट्रिक्ट एंड ब्लॉक लेवल वर्कशॉप्स and the scripts and performances were developed during that time. Collecting information about the literacy status in every household was an important activity of the campaign. The survey team, comprising mainly of well-motivated government officials, teachers and other individuals, moved from door to door listing the number of literate and illiterate persons in each household and also motivating the educated to come forward and volunteer to teach. During the survey of the 856 villages of the district, about 3 lakh persons were identified as illiterate in the age group 6 to 40 years. 26,374 in the 6 to 8 age group, 54,555 in the 9 to 14 age group, and 2,14,991 in the 14 to 40 age group. There are 581 primary schools and 173 upper primary schools in the district. The total number of secondary schools is 78, and there is only one degree college in Dungarpur. Holding public meetings in villages, mobilizing support from all the development departments of the district, and bringing together people from different segments of society under one campaign. All this has been a monumental task. Mr. Ropi Saini, collector of Dungarpur district, has played a pivotal leadership role in organizing and managing the campaign effort.
The real success of any program, you know, and particularly a program like this, Total Literacy, it depends on the environment you build. We plant in our own way, looking at the history, the cultural ethos, and the social life of the people of Dungarpur. Now this started with the celebration of Sankalp Divas. On that particular day, in every village in the district, in every town of the district, there was a function where all the students, all the citizens of the town, of the village, got together. Then for 1 hour, there was talks and programs about literacy. And then they went into, in the form of procession throughout the village and throughout the town. And then they shouted slogans. They also did wall writing. And that created a mahal.
The rich cultural tradition of the region is used in good measure to attract audiences, and these cultural performances are repeated periodically in each of the 856 villages of the district to sustain interest in the program.
एक पिछड़ा जिला, एक सुदूर दक्षिण का जिला नहीं माना जा करके और साक्षरता के नाम से इस जिले को जाना जाता है और एक जिले की नई पहचान बनी है।
In spite of the high degree of involvement in the literacy campaign created through the use of the cultural programs, the actual teaching-learning process is not easy to sustain. Dungarpur is an educationally backward district with the people surviving with considerable difficulty and hardship. The population is scattered in small hamlets and holding classes regularly becomes difficult. Sometimes classes are held at the work site, and the eager women use whatever is handy. They're carrying baskets or the sandy ground. Being backward educationally has also meant that there is a lack of adequately educated volunteers who could teach. However, the participation of women in large numbers has been a heartening feature, particularly in the context of the very low literacy rate of 12.88% for women in Dungarpur district. Being a predominantly tribal area, the women are certainly more outgoing and classes are conducted by men if necessary, unlike other areas of social backwardness in Rajasthan. An important feature of the total literacy campaign is the monitoring and management of the campaign. The district administration is fully committed to the program, apart from the Zilla Saksharta Samiti at the district, with its various committees to look after different aspects of the campaign, field coordinators at the Gram Panchayat level, area coordinators and block literacy coordinators have been appointed to ensure regular feedback to the district campaign committee. The impact of the campaign is being felt already. Since the launch of the campaign in 1991, there has been a 20% increase in the enrollment of students in the primary schools, and the demand for more teachers and primary school buildings has also gone up.
मेरे को लगता है इस प्रोग्राम से सबसे ज़्यादा फायदा महिलाएं उठाएगी क्योंकि वो यहीं पर हैं और उनको मौका मिल रहा है अभी इस पूरे कार्यक्रम में भाग लेने का पुरुष की संख्या मेरे अंदाज से कम हो सकती है जैसे सीजनल माइग्रेशन है यहाँ पर जब लोगों के पास खेती का काम है तब तो लोग यहीं रहते हैं और जब खेती का काम ख़त्म हो जाए तो रोज़गार के लिए लोग आसपास चले जाते हैं
We are planning in such a way that these people who migrate, they attend these classes during the period when they are here. And that is why we have taken it in two phases. In first phase, we will be covering only 50% of the population who can easily be covered. Now, next phase will be the people who are very difficult, who are living in remote areas. They will be covered under the second phase. And also the people who migrate,
While it is hoped that the second phase of the campaign will be able to attract the migrant labor force on their return to the villages, training adequate number of volunteers remains a nagging problem. The Akhar Doots are often too young and immature to take on the difficult task of adult literacy under formidable field conditions.
वैसे कठिन है तो ये अब पढ़ा नहीं यहाँ हम बुलाते थे उनको एक तो घर जाके बुलाना पड़ता है वैसे
लोगों के पास में सब क्या है कि एक तो लोग सोचते थे हमारे पास में टाइम नहीं है हमें पढ़ के क्या करना है दूसरी बात एक दूसरे की शर्म थी साहब
ऐसा है कि हम तो घोल के पिला दे सकते हैं लेकिन आते हैं तो पढ़ाते ही पढ़ाते पढ़ाते जो टाइम तो लगेगा
The other problem is the lack of non-formal education centers for the working children. They have to attend the adult education classes. While this may be acceptable as a stopgap measure, the needs of these children are different, and establishment of night schools or non-formal education centers is the only way to ensure that these children complete their basic education up to the primary level.
नहीं बेसिकली हम लोग ज़्यादा इन्वॉल्व हुए एक तो ट्रेनिंग का डिज़ाइन करने में
जो कि मटेरियल डेवलप किए हैं जैसे आकर झोपड़ी वगैरह
हाँ हाँ उसमें भी हम लोग इन्वॉल्व हुए हैं हाँ। जो एक्चुअली जिस तरह की प्रॉब्लम्स हैं यहाँ पर उन चीज़ों को हमने करिकुलम में भी डलवाया है ये जो साक्षरता का कार्यक्रम है वो हमारा एक भी हमारा ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का भी काफ़ी बेसिक ऑब्जेक्टिव है कि लोगों में लिटरेसी बढ़े और अवेयरनेस आए तो वो चाहे सरकार का कार्यक्रम हो या किसी का भी हो हम तो कर ही रहे और हमको करना ही है अगर सरकार कुछ कर रही है हम जरूर उसमें चाहते हैं कि उनको एक सपोर्ट दें
तो जैसे रात को कार्यक्रम हुए तो वहाँ पर भी जैसे गिनीवर्म के बारे में बतलाते हैं या सैनिटेशन के बारे में बतलाते हैं साक्षरता के गीत भी वहाँ पर गाए जाते हैं तो सरकारी काम भले ही हो पर इसको काम हम अपना ही मानते हैं और अपना मानने के कारण से उन लोगों को भी इसके लिए प्रतिबंधित कर दिया हम लोगों ने स्काउट्स को खासतौर से हमारे स्काउट्स को कि वो भी साक्षरता के लिए अपना पूरा इन्वॉल्वमेंट दें क्योंकि आखिर हमारा अपना गांव है हमारा अपना जिला है हमारे अपने लोग हैं यदि ये लिटरेट हो जाएंगे शिक्षित हो जाएंगे तो अपने गांव का ही भला है
इंटरेस्टिंगली इनफ द वॉलंटरी एजेंसीज एंड द पीपल देमसेल्व्स हैव कम फॉरवर्ड होलहार्टेडली इन सपोर्ट ऑफ द टीएलसी thus exercising a social pressure on the learners to join the program.
तो हमारे गांव वाले इकट्ठा होकर चारों पर उन भाइयों को और आदमी को कह दिया है कि कोई भी पर्दे को नहीं जाएगा ना इसको कुछ नहीं मिलेगा सरकार तरफ से इसलिए हमारे सरपंच साहब ने कह दिया ना इसलिए सब आते हैं
हाँ
सब मेरा मेरी औरतें और मेरे को कह दिया सरपंच ने कि आपकी औरत भेजना जरूरी है, आपकी औरत भेजना जरूरी है, नहीं भेजोगा तो आप गुनहगार बनोगा।
कुछ जगहों पे डीलर्स ने राशन देना जो है उसमें भी थोड़ा रोक लगा दिया है कि भाई तुमको जब राशन जब ही मिलेगा कि तुम वो अपने पर्यवेक्षक से सर्टिफिकेट लाओगे कि तुम क्लास में पढ़ने जा रहे हो, तो मतलब छोटी छोटी सी बातें ये प्रभावित करती है।
We have been able to convince the people that the literacy or being literate is essential for the man. And this is just a vehicle to the ultimate objective, that is the economic and social development. And you know, it is the only way in which the exploitation of the poor, the illiterate, can be removed.
The total literacy campaign in Dungarpur is currently in midstream. The daunting task of making over 3 lakh learners functionally literate under very difficult economic and environmental conditions has only partly been accomplished. It is yet to be seen if the hopes and aspirations of the people of Dungarpur will be fulfilled. Will they be able to keep their milk accounts and write a letter? Will they not be exploited by the moneylenders anymore? Will the total literacy campaign return to them their lost confidence and strength so that they may live with dignity once again?
તમે ભણ્યા લખ્યા હો તો ટાબર તાજા થાવેગા, તમે ભણ્યા લખ્યા હો તો ટાબર તાજા